Well, we have known for a long time that people who engage in such activities can have flashbacks months and years after usage, that a lot of their abilities can be impaired at the time of use. So why would we throw into the mix something else that can impair people? We have enough impaired people already.
All right, folks, welcome back. That was Dr. Ben Carson, who we spoke with yesterday on the Steve Malzberg Show. And we were talking about marijuana, and he believes we're headed towards a more hedonistic society, which can be turned around, but marijuana, one of those ingredients. Joining us now is Martin Lee, director of Project CBD, projectcbd.org, a pro-medical marijuana group and author of Smoke Signals. And welcome back, Martin. How are you, sir?
Good, thank you. Nice to be with you.
Thank you. Well, yeah, if you heard what Ben Carson said, the most profound thing he did was at the end ask, why would we want another substance out there, to mess people's minds up when we already have it? There's a new government survey out from the CDC out today out of Atlanta that shows 23% of high school students said they recently smoked marijuana. Only 18% smoked regular tobacco cigarettes. And this is the first time that more teenagers have tried and smoked marijuana than cigarettes. So, I don't understand why the need, medical use aside for now, why a law like the one in Colorado would be celebrated in any way, shape, or form.
Well, for starters, prohibition of marijuana that dates back to 1937 on the federal level is really based on a mountain of lies, and it's nice to have laws that reflect reality rather than political elites, what they wanted to impose at the time.
But what is the lie?
Well, the idea that marijuana, if you smoke a joint, you go out and kill your brother.
Well, I don't know. I don't know who said that, but are you denying that marijuana is a mind-altering substance?
No, mildly so. It's been used for over 4,000 years, both medicinally and even somewhat recreationally. But the fact of the matter is, whether we like it or not, whether we think it's indicative of a more hedonistic society or not, it's out there. People are doing it. Young people doing it.
Hey, crack is out there. Cocaine is out there. They're all out there, right?
Well, a lot of things are out there, and some things are actually harmful, many of those that you just mentioned. But cannabis actually doesn't show a harm in terms of health effects when you look at the demographics, and there is no scientific consensus, and I should emphasize this, that marijuana is harmful to a young person's brain.
Really?
This is something.
So you have no problem with the kids smoking marijuana?
No, I don't think it's a good idea for kids to smoke marijuana, and I'm very concerned if someone's, particularly a young person, smokes it in excess. That would suggest something is wrong. Fortunately, if they're smoking marijuana rather than drinking, binge drinking and so forth, they're at least not injuring their brain cells.
Really? Wait. It says you. What we just heard from the former chief of neurosurgery for pediatric neurosurgery at Johns Hopkins University, Dr. Ben Carson, who said that for one thing, there's proof that there's hallucinations that go on for years and years and years with the most limited of smoking of marijuana. But you say, oh, there's no brain effect at all.
You know, no, actually it does have an effect on the brain. It has a neuroprotective effect. That's what the science shows. The preclinical science that is based on animal studies, there hasn't been a lot of research on humans because the federal government won't allow it because it's prohibited. So you both to use it and to research it. Ben Carson, you know, that's a wild one. I've heard a lot of crazy
things. It's a what?
A wild one, what he said. I've heard
a wild
lot of
one, yeah.
Things said about marijuana. I've heard that it makes young men grow breasts, large breasts. I've heard all kinds of kooky stuff that the federal government has come out with, all sorts of disinformation. And people are wise to it. That's why the law passed in Colorado and Washington to legalize for adult use.
All right, so you got babysitters who'll be watching kids smoking a joint. You got people who are going to smoke and get in their car. You can't get away from the question that not only Ben Carson asked, but I think people whose brains are not affected, with all due respect, by marijuana, why on earth would you legalize another substance that's going to alter your mind, that if you do abuse it, you're going to cause havoc not only on yourself but on others? I'm not saying you're going to kill your brother, but you're going to walk around the street stoned, you're going to cross the street stoned, you're going to get on a subway stoned, you're going to get in your car stoned. Why on earth would you make that legal?
Well, people are already doing
it. Why on earth would you make it legal?
There are many reasons to make it legal, because it's never been illegal in the first place.
No. Wait, time out. What are you talking about? It's never been illegal. Wait, what is that? What does that mean? That sounds like, with all due respect, that sounds like an answer from a pothead. What do you mean it's never been illegal? It's never been illegal to smoke marijuana?
You didn't hear what I said. I said it should never have been made illegal in the first place.
I thought you said it's never been illegal in the first place.
No, I didn't say that. It was based on racism, the early laws.
Racism.
You just tell me, at what point did the federal government actually start giving us the straight dope about marijuana? We know what they were saying back in the 1930s.
You said it was made illegal in the 30s or the 20s. How was that? So they did it to get at blacks back then? Is that it?
They were saying things like white women who smoke marijuana will lust after black men. It was all about sexual contact across color lines and segregated America. It was all hooey. And what I want to know is, when did the federal government actually ever start telling the truth about marijuana? The official position is marijuana is a dangerous substance with no medical value. That's tantamount to saying the moon is made of green cheese. That's where the federal government is at. Republican, Democrat alike, the moon is made of green cheese.
Why would you want kids to smoke marijuana? Why would you want kids to have the option of smoking marijuana, or 18-year-olds or 19-year-olds or anybody to be able to legally smoke marijuana, to add another mind-altering substance out there that they could legally walk around smoking? Why would you want that for our society?
I don't want kids going around smoking. They already are. And the fact of the matter is, let's start educating people and start telling the truth about these things, so that when kids hear something from their elders about a drug, they actually believe them. They've heard all this nonsense about marijuana.
Yeah, so telling kids it's legal, that's going to make them not smoke it, right?
They try it themselves, and they say, you know, they still are A students if they started as A students.
It doesn't make a
student into an A student.
No negative effect from marijuana. Hey, you know, Martin, I got to go, but it was a great discussion. Martin Lee, director of Project CBD, that's projectcbd.org, and his book is Smoke Signals. Thank you, Martin. I appreciate it. Here on the Steve Malzberg Show, what can I say, folks? You know, no negative effects from marijuana. I don't know what universe that's in. But anyway, Joe Bastardi will join us next. Talk about the weather on the Steve Malzberg Show, Newsmax TV and radio.
But we have no.
The Steve Malzberg Show.